tuishi kwa amani, tutimize na malengo yetu. Jumuiya yetu sote tuilinde, tuajibike, tuimarike. Umoja wetu ni nguzo yetu, idumu jumuiya yetu.
Asante sana. Tuko tumesimama hivyo, hivyo ni waombe maombi ya kufungua rasmi.
Good morning. Let's believe and pray. Everlasting Father, we come before you this morning. We say thank you for the second day of the Girls Summit. Lord, you are grateful you've enabled us to see this day. And as we come before you, we pray for your mercy. We pray for your favor. We pray for your strength. We pray that you may be with us as we begin until the end. May you bless each their day. We pray for joy, we pray for peace, we pray that you may help them and guide them to achieve all that they are planning to have. And all the dignitaries who are going to be part of us, Lord, we pray that you bless them wherever they are on their way. May you continue protecting them and guide them. And as we work towards helping the girls of our country, in your holy name, amen.
Asante sana. Let us appreciate Rebecca from Stretchers Youth Organization kindly. Wacha nisikie kama tuko tayari kwa siku ya pili. Tuko tayari ama hatuko tayari? Wacha nisikie. Girls Summit 2023, oye! Chini sana bado. Girls Summit 2023, oye! Mbona bado tuko chini? Ya tatu na ya nguvu sahihi.
Pale nyuma wale wase. Wanakusinya pia.
Kama kawaida eh. Wacha nisikie ya mwisho. Girls Summit 2023, oye!
Oye!
Girls Summit 2023, oye! Tuko tayari kwa siku ya pili. Are we ready? Are we ready? Asante sana. Kwa sasa, kabla tuja mpatia Evans nafasi ya waite ambao watakuwa wanafanya panel discussion ya kwanza, I want to kindly ask one participant from Moyote, kikundi cha Moyote wako na shairi, waje tupatie shairi moja, short poetic performance, so that we can officially now go on with our program. So kindly, nani yuko wapi huyo? Our young poet from Moyote. Who is the young poet? Ama mko wengi? Eh? Jana mlitisha, kumbukeni mshaeka standard hapa, ikiteremka shida lenu. Makofi kwa Moyote tafadhali. A round of applause to Moyote tafadhali with an amazing poetic performance. So our first panel discussion, kindly be ready immediately after this amazing performance. You will be coming on stage. Naomba tuchukue nafasi hapa mbele. I also kindly want to ask everyone who is out there and specifically came for this amazing, amazing summit, aingie ndani tafadhali, aingie ndani. Kwa sasa, hawa wako na shairi moja, na iwe shairi moja, kisha tuendele.
So wakishamaliza, Nyokabi and your team will take the stage so that we proceed with the next panel. We start with the first panel discussion. Unahitaji microphone?
Bila shaka, asante.
Ladies and gentlemen, in front of you is Moyote GYWs, ready to present to you a poem entitled
The Cry of a Girl Child.
Welcome.
Peace, peace, peace is all I want. A young girl like me, I have seen more than my ears. Yes.
Shivering,
fear,
and trauma.
Every five fears, call it a general election. Do I deserve this? Political leaders, don't mix me in your mix.
Peace, peace, peace is all I want. I'm a Kenyan child.
Wanjiku is my best friend in school. Sunday school.
Acheno is my friend in school.
Political leaders, stop teaching me otherwise.
Peace, peace, peace is all I want. Venerable young me, I got this plate in my own country.
My father was killed.
My brother's hand was cut.
And my sister was raped. We lacked food and slept outside for you again.
Do I deserve this?
Political leaders, don't mix me in your mix. Peace, peace, peace is all I want.
I'm suffering.
I call for my rescue. I need help. I suffer.
I skip classes
when menstruating. I can't afford sanitary pads. I suffer sexual abuse, early marriages, drug trafficking, female genital mutilation. When will this be addressed? How will it be addressed without peace and cohesion? Peace, peace, peace is all I want. Political leaders, don't mix me in your mix. Thank you.
Make some noise for Moyote. Wanasema peace, peace.
Peace, peace. Peace is what they want.
Exactly, amazing, amazing. So right now, Evans kindly bring on stage our amazing moderators and our panelists for the first discussion on women empowerment.
Asante sana. Thank you very, very much, MC Mamboleo. And right away, we just want to kick off this program, and we will start with our first panel discussion, where we will be discussing on issues around women empowerment, leadership, and all those kind of barriers that are affecting our women to participate in the leadership position. And in this amazing, amazing panel, it will be led by none other than Nyokabi and her team. Please, Nyokabi, come on stage so that you can be able to introduce your panel. All the panels for panel one, tafadhali, let us follow. Makofi, jamani, makofi.
Makofi kwa Nyokabi,
makofi
tafadhali.
Nyokabi. Makofi, makofi. Thank you, Nyokabi. You can have a seat. And your team can be able to sit. Then you can be able to take us through this conversation. Tafadhali, kwa wale mbao huko, tumekaa, tunaomba tukue kimya. Simu zetu tuzieke katika hali ya mtekerenyo. Tuweke simu katika hali ya mtekerenyo, tafadhali.
Mtekerenyo?
Hali...
Mtekerenyo ni vibration.
Ni vibration.
Inatekerenya.
Vibration ni kutekerenya, ndugu. Hiyo ndio lugha sanifu. Asante sana. Nyokabi, please take charge.
Okay. Mic check. Good morning, everyone. For those who don't know me, my name is Nyokabi Ngare. I am the executive director and founder of African Woman Global Network. Our organization offers access to justice to people in the marginalized communities. And our main focus, our main area of focus is on succession and early child marriages. So with me, I have a panel, and I'm going to introduce their names as we go on with the discussion. So I have with me Velgona Nyangaresi. She's from Young Women Christian Association. I also have with me Josephine Cavata from African Women Global Network. And I have Sheila Waihega from Young Women Christian Association. And I have Winfred Okebe from Helping Hands. Okay, so I'm going to start, we're going to start our conversation, and they're going to give an introduction of themselves as we move along. Thank you. So Velgona, I'll start with you.
Yes, Nyokabi.
Please introduce yourself and tell us something about yourself.
Good morning, everybody. My name is Velgona Nyangaresi Nyaboke from YWCA Kenya, Kisi branch. I'm a young woman, I'm a young mother. I'm passionate about empowering the young girls and women in our society. And through that, we have a running program that is Young Women for Advocacy, Accountability, Awareness, and Agency.
Yeah. Okay, fantastic. I'll go ahead and ask you the questions so that we move faster with time. What are some of the challenges or key challenges faced by young women in Kenya today with regards to women empowerment?
I'm going to state the challenges that young women face. More so in my community, the number one challenge that we have is the cultural belief. So in the Kisii community where I come from, we have a situation whereby the culture does not allow a young woman to be a leader. Young women, we are treated to be inferior because tunazua like role yetu sisi kama wanawake ni kukaa kwa nyumba, do the house chores, give birth, take care of the kids and everything. So when it comes to taking up the roles like in leadership, maybe an empowerment, unapata like atupewi your chance to take part in the leadership initiative. And number two challenge that we have is we have lack of enough resources. As much as we're being empowered, we have the knowledge and we have the skills, we don't have the resources that will allow us to maybe to carry out project as a woman. As a woman, I'm empowered so that I can be able to take care of myself or to take care of my family or to take care of my community. Because of lack of resources, I'm in a situation whereby I cannot do anything. You know, I just have to sit down and wait for my husband to come and maybe give me money. We also have a challenge of menstrual poverty. Like as a young woman, lack of access to menstrual hygiene products due to lack of financial constraints will not allow me to go to school because of my situation of menstrual hygiene. And lastly, the last challenge that we have is non-supportive parents. You know, for a young woman, once you're a teen mother and you don't have parents who can support you, you know, at the end of the day, you just have to quit school. You just have maybe to go out there and look for money because, you know, you have nobody to empower you. So, like support from our parent will enable us maybe to get access to more empowerment programs or mentorship programs. Yeah. Thank you, Nyokabi.
Thank you very much, Velgona. That was very impactful. And I think my takeaway from her from what she's presented is, for me, I feel like it's very sad to have an unsupportive parent, but it would be understandable to some extent based on where maybe someone is coming from and looking at the fact that there's a lot of there are many people who are not employed, so there's that challenge of employment. And I also take home that culture does not allow women to be leaders. I think that's very, it's something that when you look at most communities in Kenya, we find that there are so many people who do not allow women to be leaders in their communities. And maybe that is something that we need. That mindset is something that we need to look into, and maybe try and see if there are policies that we can come up with to change change that kind of mentality. I'll go to my next panelist, Josephine. Josephine, maybe you can tell us something about yourself.
Thank you, Nyokabi, for giving me this opportunity. My name is Josephine Kavata from African Women Global Network. One unique thing about me is that I'm proud being a young mother. I carry along my son and I don't feel shameful. Since the African Women Global Network came to the Mukuru slums and empowered us, educated us, the shame that I had standing in front of my friends, yeah, they parted ways with me just because I decided to be a teenage mother, lost away. I'm proud and I feel honored to be here.
Thank you very much, Josephine. I'll ask you a question. I get so emotional usually when I hear young girls speak. So anyway, what are the main challenges faced by young women in accessing education in Kenya?
Okay, I will share my experience as a slum girl. I come from Mukuru slums. I don't know if the challenges I may share may consider the other slums, but as for me, let me share a brief story about me. I studied and finished my studies at Class 8, attained 372 marks, but I got no scholarship, so I no longer continued with my studies. Went to Aladwa's office, walked through a certain lawyer at Makadara Law Courts, went to the DCC, went to the chief, submitting my papers, but at all, my fruits bore no. So the main challenges we face as a slum girl. We come from poor families, so our parents don't have money. Unapata awatoto awendi shule kwa sababu ya nini? Unapata sometimes mzazi yako akona watoto wengi wenye haizi manage kwenda shule. So unapata wengine wanabaki kwa nyumba, wengine wakienda shule. Yourself to go to school, it's impossible. So your syllabus, your siku na miss. And second thing is the line of child, the lineage family. Unapata, I experienced a certain mother who is my friend, akona 8 children. So unapata, out of 8 children, none of them mwenye anenda shule. Kwa sababu ya nini, akona katoto kadogo, watoto ni wengi. So unapata akona shida mob na hakuna msee mwenye anamsupport, ye peke yake ndo anajisupport. So kwa watoto wote wako tu kwa nyumba, sometimes hawana kitu ya kukula, wako tu. So inabidi atembee kwa ma neighbors kidogo, at least apate kitu yenye watoto wake watafanya nini, watakula. But si kila siku utatembea kwa neighbor unamwambia nisaidie na food. Saa zingine unanyamazia tu your story. Then another thing is story ya rape cases. Mukuru slums kuna rape cases mob. Unapata sometimes watoto hawaendi shule just because of what. Huyu mtoto anajua ile njia yenye natumianga nikienda shule, kuna mtu fulani ananitegea, unaona? So unapata haezi manage. Yeah? Aya, kuna this other thing, lack of infrastructure, roads za kwetu ziko mbaya. When it rains it gets muddy, our watoto hawezi manage kuenda shule. Then kuna insecurity, yeah, kwetu kuko kubaya, sio kuzuri. So we need security there in order for our girls kufanya nini, kumanage kuenda shule. Na mimi personally, to be a young mother, ningetamani kuendelea na shule hiyo time. Nilimalizanga class 8 but sikupata scholarship. I rest my case.
Thank you very much, Kabata. Thank you very much. Wow, those are so many points. I'm actually very, I feel like most of them apply to so many of these communities. And I think it's something that maybe we need to call out to action for people who are in the slums, whereby they need to find ways in which security can be deployed in those communities. And also, my take home from this is also the lack of infrastructure, rape cases, poverty and support for education for young people in the slums. I'll move on to my next speaker. Sheila. Sheila, please tell us something about yourself.
Thank you. Good morning. Good morning. So my name is Sheila Waihiga. I'm from YWCA Meru branch. I am very passionate about talking about girls and the challenges they face. Most of the times we don't talk about it, but it affects all the generations, yeah, from your grandmother, the generations before. So I'm passionate about empowering women and talking about what we can do to make our world a better place to live in.
Okay, thank you very much. So I go to the question. How do you think we can increase the representation of young women in leadership position in Kenya? And what role do you think men can play in this effort?
Thank you very much.
I repeat the question?
Yeah.
Okay. How do you think we can increase representation of young women in leadership position in Kenya? And what role do you think men can play towards this increase of representation?
Okay, as a society, I have come to realize that most of the time, the cultural norms limit women to take up the spaces that are for leadership. So most of the times you're told you're a woman, you can't vie for a certain place. And I thank God for the format he's taken us. Because now we can, the constitution is there, women can vie for these places, but again the society doesn't support them. So what we can do, we can start with the women in leadership. They should come and motivate the young girls in the society, uko chini kwa grassroots, kwa ground. So as a leader, I'm from Meru, so the leaders, when you get into that position, I feel like as a leader you should come and listen to what they have to say and encourage them. Most of the time we find failure because of the mindset we have towards certain things. So if we are able to change that mindset, I think we can increase the number of women leaders in the higher spaces in leadership. The second thing I think, it's educating women. Girls, they go to school, but during their menstrual cycle, some of them are not able to go to school due to lack of sanitary towels. And it is really heartbreaking to see a girl miss classes and at times they are forced to repeat and they get discouraged. So if we are able to make these products available to them, it will be very nice in encouraging girls to go to school. The second thing is the insecurity. So if we girls are at risk of getting raped while going to school or around the community, you see, or there is war, theft. So these things are affecting girls, and I think they should be taken into, action should be taken to bring more girls into leadership. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Sheila. My takeaway from what you brought out is intergenerational mentorship. I think it's very key for us to have ways in which we can connect our senior leaders and our youth, because maybe that is one thing that will come in and bridge the gap in leadership. Is that the point that you want to bring out?
Yeah.
Okay.
And about the men.
Yes.
The men, as you should be role models to your sons. Wataenda treat their girlfriends or their wives the same way. And if you're raising daughters, teach them how to love themselves. Always assure them they are capable of something great. At times we just need a pat on the back to tell us, okay, uko sawa, go ahead and do it. Supportive male masculinity, it really encourages women. If you support your wife, you're supporting an entire generation, because your children will be respectful to their wives, those who are men. The ladies will also go far. So in a way, if you change one family, it's like you're changing an entire community.
Okay. Thank you very much, Sheila. In the interest of time, I think we'll go to... Okay, tell us about yourself, Winfred.
Good morning. My name is Winfred Okebe. I'm from Helping Hands Organization. So for me, I like women empowerment. And I'd really love one day to see a woman president, especially in Kenya. Because we have the numbers, but my worry is when it comes to voting, where are the votes? Thank you.
Winfred, I know you're very passionate about women, and I know you have a lot to say about women, but now I'll ask you, what role can men play in supporting women empowerment?
For men, what I would love to say is that if you get a woman that is learned, kindly support the woman. Most women, after giving birth, they find it hard to go back and look for money or to fend for themselves. Try and create an opportunity for them. Comes to schooling, most men are like, if I take her back to school, oh, she'll leave me at a niacha. But what I always like putting in men's heart or in their mind, I don't know if it's life or it's godly created, that most men die before their wives. And here you leave your wife with your kids. So in the society, you come to see that once a man is dead, you hear people say, tangu husband wake akufe, mama, ona venye watoto wanateseka. They were going to a group of schools. Ata sikuzi shule hawaendi. Men, be very keen in supporting your wife. You'd rather support your wife, alafu muachane hivyo, lakini watoto wako, obviously, when there's separation, it's always women who go with the kids. I think it's always good, or you'll feel good, that at a, there are some women. She can raise the kids. As a man, I kindly ask, support your wife. Kama ni biashara, try and help her do the business. Kama ni shule anataka kurudi and you have finances, don't limit her. Take her to school. And lastly, learn to tell your daughters and your wife you love them. Most of the teenage pregnancies that we have, it's just because a man amemwambia tu, I love you. It's just the word. It's not even something very much important. Love your kids. Tell them, even if they fail, kama ni msichana, mwambie, I love you. You'll do better. Encourage them. What every word that is coming from your mouth, let it be something that can encourage your kid. Mtoto wako akikapa hali anasema, eh, my dad or my mom is always telling me I can do it. And then, it's not, don't just look the in the perspective of education only. We have kids who have talent. People are talented outside. Yeah, ladies are talented. Some can sing, some can play. Take them to such events. Waone, encourage them. And also, once your wives have given birth, tafuta anybody who can help her psychologically. Because also, mental issues zinakujanga. Whatever people are passing through now, mainly it's about, it's mental. So if we can get support from our men to take us to somebody who we can talk to, especially after giving birth, being let it be continuous, not only after giving birth, if you want somebody to talk to, you cannot be talking to your wife, your sister every time. They will not understand. But if you get somebody who is, it's like that is their job, somebody different, you can open up, you can talk to them, and at least the burden that you have as a woman, it akwa somehow relieved. So men, support your wives in every area, not only giving them children. Thank you.
Wow. I love that. And I think my takeaway was I loved the point you made on support. I think we live in a community that culture really overtakes a lot of what we believe in as a society, and we live in a community where men hide properties from women and women hide properties from men. And as she said, we hide all these things, but at the end of the day, it's the kids who get to suffer. A point you brought out was on how maybe the man passes on, and then the woman is left wondering, how do I take care of, or how do I continue with this standard that this man has set? So I think that's a very important point. And I also like the point of encouraging and sharing love. And I feel like our culture, again, back then did not teach our parents how to show love. So there was, maybe this generation is the one that is able to teach or show love to our children, where we are able and comfortably able to tell our children we love them. But our parents then were not able to do the same. They felt that is maybe a mzungu thing. So, yeah, but I like the points that you brought out. I don't know how much time we have. If I can probably go around and maybe you guys can give a closing remark. I can start with you, Velgona.
I would like to say it's good to empower the young women and girls in our society. Most of our young women and girls are like, they are depressed, going through a lot. Let us give a safe space whereby somebody can feel like safe. She can be in a position whereby I can come and tell you this is what I'm going through. Don't judge me. But at the end of the day, I need your help. And as a woman, they always say, once you educate a girl, you have educated the whole society. Let's make sure that our young girls are educated. We impact them with the knowledge and skills so that in future we can
Yeah, as Winfred said, we can have a woman president in this Kenya of ours. Thank you so much.
Thank you very much, Belgona. Josephine, please give us your closing remarks.
Thank you, Nyokabi. Mine is just to say that the African Woman Global Network has done a good job by empowering us. So, if for me, I would like to ask which other organization feels right to walk down to Mukuru slums, come and talk to girls about the drug and substance abuse, because it's a higher rate. Imagine a young girl like me walking down to Changa dance, yeah, using the alcohol. Maybe back in her mind, she doesn't know the side effects of drugs. That's all I have.
Thank you very much. Sheila?
Thank you very much, Nyakabe. My last remarks are, let's empower women. Women have a, they have a greater role in the society. If one can bring up children to be great people, so imagine if they're given this leadership position, what are they going to do with them? And let's talk to girls. Let's give them the hope that some of them have lost, which will enable them to move on in life. And let's create safe spaces for girls to talk. Let them feel free, unjudged, no stigma, and all will be well. Thank you.
Thank you, Sheila. Winfred?
My last remarks are, women, let's support women, especially when it comes to social media. If you are passing through social media and you see I've posted or another woman has posted something that you don't like, kindly just leave the page. Yeah? It's not a must for you to diminish her or for you to talk badly. It's like you want her to feel depressed or something. Just let's try and avoid this social media bullying. If you feel like somebody has posted something that you don't like, kindly just avoid it. Don't be number one. If you see all of the comments in just some funny post that a fellow woman has, realize that it's us women that use us to pull us down. So kindly, let's support each other. If you feel like somebody has posted, I'm very keen on social media, kindly avoid the page, avoid the comments, just move on. Let's support each other where you feel like I can comment here, kindly comment. If you feel like this post, whatever I'll want to comment is annoying, just let it pass. Thank you.
Thank you very much. I think Winfrida, you need like a whole day to speak about women empowerment. But anyway, thank you very much for joining this panel. It was good moderating this session. And thank you very much for listening to us and listening to our wisdom. Thank you very much and have a lovely day.
I think we can do better. 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 Thank you so much, Nyokabi, African Women Global Network, for the wonderful work that you guys are doing. Keep doing you. Keep doing what you're doing so that you can be able to save as many lives as possible. Quite inspiring stories that we have listened, and we hope that the many organizations that are here, we can follow the footsteps of the African Global Women Global Network of the wonderful work they're doing. MC Mamboleo, what
asante
do you have?
Asante sana. Dada yetu Nyokabi na kikundi chako kwa mjadala mkubwa, mjadala wenye tija, mjadala wenye nguvu, mjadala wenye maneno ya kutosha. Au sio? Kwa sasa, nataka nikaribishe kikundi kingine ambacho kina mjadala wenye usaidizi mkubwa sana kwenye taifa letu sasa. We understand the huge conversation around issues to do with climate change. not just in Nairobi, but also in Kenya and Africa as a region. Most importantly, I also want to mention the correlation between climate change and sexual health. So right now, ladies and gentlemen, and our amazing participants, I want to call on stage the moderator for this very, very special session, Purity Jebor from CCGD. Make some noise for Purity Jebor. Akwapi.
Purity Jebor.
Amependeza sana. Tumpigie makofi mpaka afike hapa. Anatembea pole pole kwa madaha na mikogo.
Kiupole.
Asante sana. So immediately after Purity, kindly take your seat. Thank you. I also want to call the four amazing panelists. One is Janet Dete. Akwapi Janet Dete kwa heshima nyingi sana.
Makofi yanapokuja.
Wa pili ni Catherine Mwangi.
Makofi yanapokuja. Kwa haraka upesi tukimbie.
Watatu wamepeana jina moja.
Tukimbie tafadhali.
Jina moja kama Nairobi.
Catherine kimbia tafadhali. Unaweza.
Watatu wamepeana jina moja anaitwa Naserian. Najua majina yake mawili. All the way from Isiolo County. Godano
Yusu.
Karibu sana. Asante sana.
Asante, anatembea kwa madaha, kwa taratibu, pesi.
Asante sana. Na nataka niwaambie hii ni mada ya Mheshimiwa Rais. Hii mada ya climate change ni mada ya Mheshimiwa Rais. Karibuni sana.
Thank you.
Thank you so much and happy to moderate this session. My name is Purity Jebor, the Youth Coordinator for Collaborative Center for Gender and Development, a passionate young woman on climate change, but also to give a gender perspective, to identify the place of women and especially the place of young women in all this conversation. But for today, I have an amazing panelist who will be taking us through to for us to understand the intersectionality between climate change and sexual reproductive health. So, karibuni sana. I'm happy to have you here today. So, I will start with Janet. Please tell us your name and tell us what you do in 30 seconds.
My name is Janet Dete. I'm from Madare. I'm from the She Leads program. I'm a social and green entrepreneur. I'm also an innovator and the founder of Queening Africa, where we recycle bread waste to make trendy accessories as a way of women advocating for climate change in our community. Thank you.
Thank you so much.
Hi, everyone. My name is Catherine Mwangi from Mathare Sub-County, Kiamaiko Ward, from Plan International, She Leads, and an organization called Shine a Light. I'm passionate about young women and young girls, making sure that we have a safe environment for all our girls. Thank you.
Karibu sana, Kate Naserian.
Good morning, everybody. My name is Millicent Naserian. I know you were told one name, but my first name is Millicent Naserian. I am from Narok, Kenya. I currently serve as the Youth Senator for Narok County and an organization called the Youth Senate of Kenya. And I'm passionate about issues of democracy, gender issues, especially in advocacy for cultural norms for the girl child, especially now from the Maasai community, FGM. And I'm so glad to be here. I'll be happy to share with you.
Thank you. And she was seconded by the UNFPA Youth Advisory Board. Thank you so much, Naserian. Karibu Godana.
Thank you very much. Good morning. The energy in this room is a bit off. Good morning. My name is Godano Yusuf. I come from Isiolo, born and raised. I am the chair for the ICPD 25 Youth Coalition, which is a national coalition formed by 320-something organizations all across Kenya. Other than that, I am also very passionate about women and girls and team lead of an organization in Isiolo. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much. So, how madame, ni madame already wanna make it within their local level, huh? So it is an inspiration that that hata kama wako hapa, you can still do something pale mtaani, yeah? So I will start off with Janet. Janet, umetombe. Kuna discussion pale, mara mingi nilisikia nasema, oh, climate change ni El Nino, El Nino tushandwe ishapita. Na saizi wona tuambia unafanya issues to do with innovation, just a way of adopting and also being resilient to climate change. Huh? Can you please dissect it for us? Tuambie in the basic understanding or even definition. Climate change ni nini? Na climate change ina contribute aje issues to do with sexual reproductive health.
Okay, climate change is the long-term shifts of temperatures and weather patterns over a long period of time. So when we connect it to SRHR, wache nionge Kiswahili pia kidogo, tukiconnect na SRHR, ni easy effects of climate change. For example, kama drought, na flood. Okay. So as I said, climate change is the long-term shift of weather patterns and temperatures over a long period of time. Na tukiconnect na SRHR, ni easy effects of climate change. For example, hizi venye mnasikia El Nino, when ukisikia El Nino si unafikiria flooding. Na pia kuna effects kama drought. So easy ukiconnect na SRHR in that seme El Nino, for example, ni venye sahi kuna jua kali, but ikikam, hiyo flooding. Uko madhare ama yu mta mnaishi. Sikuna watu wanaishi karibu na rivers. Now what? Sikuna watu wanaishi karibu na rivers. Sindio? Yes. So unaona kama kuna floods, watu wanakuwa displaced. Na displacement in affect young women and girls. In that, when people are displaced, seme mnaishi kwa tents, unapata girls are at higher risk of experiencing GBV. Wanakuwa raped, kuna physical violence just because there are floods na wakahamishwa place wanaishi. So, hakuna ile social protection. Alafu pia, tuseme kama kuna floods bado, unapata latrines zinajaa. Sisi kama madem tunahitaji clean water. Ndiyo hiyo usafi ikue. Sasa unapata, kama chozi mejaju ya flooding ni chafu, wasichana wanaweza pata UTI na bado kuna waterborne diseases. So climate change in affect mostly girls and young women compared to men. Na kama in case kuna drought, hiyo lack of food, unapata kuna mama mjamzito anahitaji chakula. Watoto wasichana wanahitaji chakula. So inaweza lead to malnutrition. And that's why the effects of climate change in affect girls, that's how it is directly connected to SRHR. Thank you.
Thank you so much. Let's appreciate her. So, can you actually, Janet anatuambia ni, wakati tunafikiri about climate change, we should also think about not just tree planting. Tree planting is one way, right? But also to think about the sexual reproductive health and see how climate change, it may place madame especially and young women, wanakuwa that it is also increasing the cases of GBV. Na kitu yenye pia ametuambia ni the place of social protection. Na hii ndio agenda yenye madem inafaa pia tupush, eh? Simesikia sezi kuna agenda the social protection. So that ukisikia gava inaita watu, enda pale na upatiane opinion yako. So, Kate, so tukikam kwako, umetuambia unatoka pale Mathare. Na congratulations, I see a baby's coming soon, and we look forward to welcome that healthy baby, right? Pale Vimtani, what are some of the issues that Madam upitia, especially when they want to access sexual reproductive health? Ineza kuwa place ya kubonga, ineza kuwa ni safe space, is it there? But also to access from the public facility. Na pia we jani yako kama demyang, imekuwaje when you are also accessing maternal health care?
Thank you so much, Purity. And the issues that young girls from Mathare, let me say from Mathare, because hapo ndio mimi natoka, ziko, and some of them ni vitu mimi mwenyewe as a person nimepitia, it's been a journey. So one of the issues is that unapata stigma from the community, society, na kupatia. Let's say mi nataka, mi ni mdemu nimejua, vile nataka. Nataka kujipanga. I want to go and assess contraception kwa hospitali. Nimeenda kwa health facility, nimewaambia, okay, misa hii, I'm not ready to have a baby. Facilities, wale watu wamekwa hapo, kitu ya kwanza wataniuliza, we msichana mdogo, umeamua ufanye ngono vile unataka. Yet, mimi nimejijua, nataka kupata services fulani, but hiyo ndio swali ataniambia. So, being a young girl, mimi kesho hapo starudi. Daenda, maybe hata ni engaging sex, yenye si safe. One thing nili make the step kwenda hospitali kupata the right services. But wenye nimepata hapo, wameni respondia aje. Another challenge unapata, yes, we have the health facility, let's say in the formal settlement, but it's just a building iko hapo. Kuna contraceptives ziko hapo zenye wasichana wanapata. Let's say me want to get tested nijue hali yangu. Ule mtu amekwa pale, ni mtu naeza kufeel comfortable kushia na yeye. Because we had one case, a young girl amekua, anataka kujua hali yake after ame interact, ame have sex, hakuwa safe, akaambiwa that if unataka kupimwa, enda ukuje na mwenye ulikuwa na yeye. So, it's a challenge, let's say mimi I was raped, nimeenda pale hospitali, nataka kuwa safe, hiyo ndio response nimetaka. Kesho ndarudi hapo, siwezi rudi. Another issue yenye unapata, tunapitia as young girls ama young mothers, ni lack of, let's say, privacy kwa community. We have those same tie to, na refer to mahali mimi naishi. Utapata, we have this CHPs, sai, before walikuwa naitua CHVs. Mimi wamepewa nyumba zao 10. Mimi being a young girl, nimepata HIV, ama I'm pregnant, I was raped. Nikaona the only person that I can share my experience with ni uyo CHV community volunteer. Ndakuwa the example of Madare kesho. Wewe ule msichana uko hivi, uko na mimba, wewe msichana ulirepiwa, I'll be an example. Na for real, itanirudisha. Chini, if we have some other girls, wangetaka kushare experiences zao, hata eza kushare kesho. Then, purity, we have that, okay, for the safe spaces, we have them, but unapata, okay, mimi being a young girl, I'm being empowered, I have the right information, but I'm going back to the same community. Environment ni same. I'm going back to the same mother, the same men, the same society, yenye ina information yenye niko nayo. So what's the use? Yes, I'm empowered. But nikirudi kwa nyumba, narudi tu, itabini nimerudi nyuma for me to be allowed kukua kwa your spaces yenye niko. So those are the some of the challenges that we are facing. Na I've been a victim wa some of them. Now, for my journey of being like now that I'm pregnant, unapata, I had, nilifanya a trial, tu kwenda mahali, nikasema, okay, me I'm pregnant, I don't know, nilipata siku gani, and the responses that I got, msichana mwenye ana information, hata enda hata your clinic, hata rudi tu kwa nyumba, acha tu ikae nigoje siku ya kujifungua. And it's sad because unapata, hiyo ni a hospital that iko kwa formal settlement. Na informal, kuna challenges zinakaa aje. So thank you so much, Purity.
Oh, thank you so much, Kate. And us being here, it is also just an assurance that we have to support you in this journey to ensure that you are accessing the highest quality standards of maternal healthcare, regardless of the location that you are coming from. But I think for me, it's also just to bring out the place of age in terms of accessing sexual reproductive health. That at the age of 18, you have a right to go and seek any sexual reproductive health that is within the Kenyan constitution. And nobody should shun you away as a young woman or as a young girl at 18 or 19. Thank you so much, Kate, for that. Now, coming to you, Nasserian, you're coming from one of the hotspots on harmful cultural practices. And right now we are talking about the ending the triple threat. And we do understand that currently we have a new trend on FGM. And it's so shocking that FGM is now with us in the city. So you can imagine, if it's already happening in the city, what is also happening in those ASAL and pastoral community? So take us through, what are those harmful cultural practices that you feel have continued promoting the practice of issues that is also affecting the sexual reproductive for young women and girls, but also nimesikia mara mingi tunasema we cannot talk about sexual reproductive health minus the boy child, eh? Yesterday there was a very interesting conversation on, can I mention the television, on Citizen. And Dr. Dorcas mentioned, there was a young man, I will not mention the county, but you can go on YouTube and watch it. That young man had impregnated 8 girls. So talk to us about social cultural practices and the place of boy child. Ndio wakati pia sisi tunamwambia we are going to do the injection, huu boy child anakuwa champion wetu, so that we have our boy child back to protect us and keep us safe, as opposed to hizi ukitoka hapa uone tu group ya maboys pale una freeze already, yeah? So welcome, Anna Seren.
Thank you so much, Purity. When we talk about cultural norms, what exactly do we mean? Cultural, when talking maybe from the cultural perspective, there are good cultural norms and there are bad cultural norms. For example, if we speak about FGM, is FGM a good cultural norm or a bad cultural norm? And does FGM happen in Kenya? Yes. Where does it happen? Not only in the ASAL areas, but we've been told even in the city. How? I'll give you an example. Recently, we were doing a study, and it was just a research. You see how you can go to informal settlements or formal settlements to just find out the progress of FGM in the areas. And when we went there, I met a 17-year-old girl. She dropped out of school at her primary school, but she was not able to continue with her education. But that was not the gist. The gist was that she had not undergone FGM before she got pregnant. But when she got pregnant and she was going to deliver, that is when she underwent FGM. How? Through a medic. Yeah, I know it would stir up a lot of questions, but it is actually happening through medics. Daktari analetwa kwenu, anakuja kukusaidia kuzalisha, maybe because you are not in a capacity to go to hospital because of the bills, because of one situation or another. And then, wanaitwa wakunga, those women who help women to give birth, they actually come to your home, and because culturally it is bad maybe, or it is a taboo, maybe from my community I'd say, they call it a taboo when a young woman gives birth without blood pouring before that. So if you had not been cut and you're giving birth and this woman is helping you, they have to pour the blood first to make you clean, to help you give birth. So she underwent FGM at the same time when she was giving birth. And that was the most painful experiences that we ever got, because it is actually a medic who performed it, and they came to their home, na wakamdunga sindano, and that is how she underwent FGM. So you see, this girl was vulnerable twice. One, she got pregnant very early while in school. And then second, when she was going to give birth, the family was not in a position to help her go to hospital. So they had to call someone home, and that is how she underwent FGM. And cultural practices exist in so many ways. Like currently, they do FGM, but in a fichwa chini ya maji. They will do it, they will call a celebration, and then it is when the boy child is being circumcised. So you find like a group of 15 boys and one girl who's hidden in there. And then when they ask, or when you ask where the girl is, they would say, ah, she's just sick. She's, you know. Kumbe, the real thing was she actually underwent FGM and then she was hidden. So it was just as if she was suffering from malaria, but in real sense, they were giving her 2 weeks to heal from FGM. And when the girls come out, they do not speak about it. The other social cultural norm is teenage marriages. Because not only in the city, even in the ASAL areas, there are so many teenage marriages that happen.
And when a family maybe is in a situation of crisis and an economical and maybe climate change crisis, what is the best option? To give the girl in exchange for money or to give the girl in exchange for cows? I'll give you also an example. From the village where I come from, there's a father who had six girls. So in the six girls, when drought really hit, he had no option. The cows were dying, the family was unable to survive. So what did he do? He gave two girls to another family so that he can get the cows to continue sustaining the other family. So you see, this in this case, climate change and cultural norms intertwine. And you see now, because of climate change, these girls were not able to continue with school, and the parents had to exchange them for cows to also be able to sustain them economically. So child marriage happens. In the city, most of the time, it's because of economical situation, where poverty is prominent, and they don't have another way of survival. So the only way is either peane msichana alipwe pole pole, and that's how they will continue to survive. Because you see, culturally, our African traditions see the girl as money. So they see the girl as an exchange for money. Maybe some other cultural norm I would tell you, or social norm, is the inequalities for education, because that one we actually categorize as a social norm. Most of the time, the boy childs are preferred to the girl childs, or maybe they see the boy child would bring more value as compared to the girl child in so many places in Kenya. So they see, like, this girl, when she goes, she doesn't have so much value. But for the boys, they feel as if the boys can bring in more value to their community and even to the whole family. So that is also one of the prominent matters. Where is the place of the boy child in this? The boy child plays a very critical role in also ending the social and cultural norms and the practices that girls go through, both in the informal settlements and in the formal settlements. How? We've seen boy childs who stood up. You see those guys who call themselves boys for? They are the boys in the girls' dominated field, because they are actually the advocates who go telling the community that whatever you do for the girls is not right, and this is the best way we can do it. And we've seen boys who've come out to actually champion, who've come out with initiatives and organizations. Like in Narok, I'd give an example. Leshan has gone miles and miles, and he's been featured internationally for what he's done for the girl child, especially in fighting for cultural norms and FGM. Also for teenage pregnancies and early marriages, because he's stood out and he's been a voice for the girl child. Very critical role to play, one in advocacy, two in standing up in the families and saying this is very wrong and we should go against it. Three is to protect the girls. How? Through reporting. If anything fishy is happening in the community, the boys should not be silent. The boys actually should be the ones who say, this is wrong, and if you actually do this, we will report you. So I think as much as the boys would play that role, all of us, it's our role to also speak about these norms, because they happen, and they happen every day. And when you keep quiet, one of the girls will suffer, or many girls will suffer. So it's our responsibility for all of us to not keep quiet when you know a social practice is happening or a cultural practice is happening, but to actually stand up and say, you know what, this is wrong, and we are going to report it, and these are the steps that we are going to use to report it. So thank you.
Wow. Nasserian, thank you so much. But just to add, if you know of any expectant mother or young woman, please tell them there is a cover called Linda Mama. It is free of charge. You only need to go to your local health facility. You get registered, and then you access free maternal health care. Hadi time ya kuzaa, then 1 year later. So don't let them go to how wakunga wa hapo hivi mtaani, and yet government is already supporting that. Thank you so much, Terian. And I think also for this summit, one of the progressive cultural norms that we have adopted, it is to have the young women talk to us, that it is no longer having the experts with us, but young women giving us their real perspective. Because number one, they're the ones who now interact with the current situation, but also the threat facing is also affecting them. Now, moving smoothly to Godana, even as we wind up. Godana, being the team lead, such a huge position and power you hold in coordinating we young people to report on ICPD 2022 and its issues to do with population and sexual reproductive health is one of the dockets that you need to spearhead. Tell us some of the challenges that you have been reading from the reports that the youth actually sending to you.
Thank you very much, Purity. It's a tough job, first of all. But also, I'm going to be a bit biased and talk, since we are on a climate change panel, I'll want to talk specifically to the assault regions in Kenya and the challenges that sexual reproductive health, especially when we are talking about young people and girls, what they face is a tad bit different. And the first statement I'll say is that the availability of adolescent-friendly services are not uniform in all the 47 counties that we have. Not every region has youth-friendly services. And why not? Because when you look at health services, youth-friendly services are connected to health services, and I can confidently say that a lot of the assault regions do not have health services in all the regions. Nigerian, you can confirm for me from Narok, right? And you'll find that as a pastoralist in most of these regions, you have to go miles and miles and miles to get even a dispensary or a hospital or a small facility, right? Which is already a challenge in itself. So you can imagine as a young person, that also adds your problem by 100% maybe. We come again to the challenge of a lot of these regions are people who are moving constantly to following water, grass, and a lot of other things. And you find that a lot of times as communities in the assault regions that the health facility is a structure. So you leave the structure and you go, going after cows and goats. So most times you'll find that there is no access to SRHR. And for us to be able to say that young people and girls and women are getting SRHR services, it means it has to be readily available to them. It's not readily available to them. I feel that is it's a structural problem, and it's also something that I would ask our government to take into consideration, not working as silos and working together. How is the Ministry of Health, Ministry of Education, Ministry of Transport, because again, even roads are terrible in those areas. How are all these different ministries and departments working together to make sure that a young girl in Mosoiro, right? Or Ntulele is getting the same services that a young girl in Karen is getting, or a young girl in Isiolo is getting. There is disparity in all these things. So we need to actually have these things. Another thing is that youth-friendly services is a strategy. And for us to be able to get that strategy and to be able to implement it, we need to also, especially as we are facing short-term climate change, we need to be able to know that how are we bringing women and girls also to advise us, to tell us that we need, this is what we can get help in. For example, she already said the challenges that she's facing, and she's in a very urban setup. So you can imagine that for because of these disparities, there is a lot of things that are seeping through the gap that we are not able to accomplish right now. So even from the reports, I'll go back to them. We have organizations from every county, and they tell us, are these commitments that our government made in 2019, we are 4 years since. Have they been met? We will say not completely. As young people, we are not feeling the impact. So we want to hold each other accountable. Government, young people, organizations, CSOs, how are we able to hold each other accountable? What is the role of the government? And this was the role of me as a CSO. What's the role of a young person? Because even the young person, you have a role in this. Because if there is a facility which is youth-friendly near you and it's not working, you need to give feedback. You cannot say, pale hawapeanangi kitu.
Thank you so much, Godana, and you've just given us the place of accountability, that as much as we say the county needs to do this, need this, what are we doing as young women? Are we also participating when those plans are being made? Are we also giving them the proposals that we want to see happening? Unezenda pale mtani na wangalile hosenye iko hapo. Je, ikopoa na mayuth wakivizitio hosi. Ukona ule doki mwenye uneza open up na unongia issues ya sex na comfortably. So in 30 seconds each, because our mantra for Nairobi is lazima iwork, yeah? Na lazima iwork for women and young girls, huh? Tell us, what do you think should work for Nairobi on climate change?
One I would love to request the government is there should be more training and advocacy on matters to do with climate change and women and SRHR, because most of the women do not have that education on how climate change affects them directly. And also, we would love the government to channel funds to women-led enterprises, NGOs, and CBOs that are really putting their efforts in fighting and ensuring that girls and young women adapt to the effects of climate change. And just one message to the girls is that you can also be green entrepreneurs. You can also be innovators and tell the president and the governor that there are a lot of women who are green innovators. We are there, but we are less. Something has to be done. Thank you.
Thank you. Yes, Kate, talk to us. What should work on maternal health care and sexual reproductive health?
Okay, thank you so much, Purity. For me, I feel that the government should not only make the policies, they should also help in promoting or creating awareness on the policies. Yes, the policies are there, but do the community know about them? Do the young girls know about them? Do the young people know about them? So there should be creating awareness of them. And also to add on the issue of the services. Acha isikuwe napata services because I have information. Let it be equal. In hospitals, as a young person, ikiingia hapo, they'll treat me right because I deserve kupata the services, not because I come from such organization, from familia fulani. It should be equal. Also, kwa police stations, they should have maybe a gender desk that is different from the na reporting crime nini fulani to a gender desk that as young people, we can be comfortable, to feel safe, to report, ama to access justice. So thank you so much, Purity.
Very good, Sanana. Serian?
Mimi kenye na feel lazima iwork ni that the government, especially the Nairobi County government and more so the Kenyan government, should come out to provide resources, because the one big problem we have is resources, financial resources especially, because you can't go on ground to do mobilization, to do advocacy without resources. Second thing is, yes, policies are done, but how many policies do we have that protect the girl child, especially in cultural practices in the city? Because they only, like in Narok, we developed a policy for FGM and a policy for the youth that mainly covers those areas. But in the city, do we actually have them? And do they protect the girl? So one thing, in the legal and in the political space, they should take the step to actually implement these policies that protect the girl child. Yes, thank you.
Thank you, Godana.
Mine, I want to repeat something that I've already said. we have to involve young people, women and girls in climate change preparedness and resilience. We cannot do without it because they're the people who are being affected highly by climate change. And especially in the SRH, when you look at it from the SRH lens, we need to involve them. And not only in communities, but also in the government. How can us as young people and young women, and how can we be able to have a preparedness strategy that is catered to us and centered to us when the time comes that we need it? That is what I'll say. And also, shameless plug, I know Evans is down Purity's throat, but shameless plug for the organizations that are here. In case you want to join the ICPD 25 Youth Coalition, please, I'll be around the whole day. And even Evans is part of the coalition. You can talk to either one of us and shoot us an email. Thank you.
Thank you so much. And do enjoy the rest of the sessions.
Asante sana. Purity, wapi makofi ya Purity. Asante sana for the wonderful job that you guys are doing. Purity, asante sana. ICPD chair, asante sana. Huyo ndo bosi yetu huyo, Kenya mzima. Huyo ndo bosi yetu kwa maswala ya ICPD. Ladies and gentlemen, we are doing so well with regards to time. Now we need to break a little bit. So we are going to break for 15 minutes. Exactly 15 minutes. Breakfast is served, palemba lunch ilikuwa served yesterday. And the same way we used kukula lunch, that is the same route we are going to use. So tunatoka tuna pale kwa ile mlango, tunaingia pale, tunachukua, tunakula faster, tunarudi hapa faster. Tafadhali, munieshimu eh? Munieshimu kama vile mulinieshimu jana.
Atuta kuheshimu wewe, tutaheshimu muda. Asante sana, tukienda tafadhali, let us come back with more vigor, more passion, na mambo kama tukirudi. We have an amazing, amazing poetry performance from one guy called Machozi ya Mwisho. Yeah? Hii ni kali sana. Jama fulani ana maneno ya nguvu sana.
Nasema tutaheshimu muda.
Tuheshimu muda.
Si mimi.
Wewe unaweza potea huko. Asanteni sana.
DJ.
See you after the break. DJ, twende kazi. Hii ni kubwa sana. This is Henrik Sam.
Ngapi hatujui jo, minasaka za kesho. Kalesa nina piga, I don't know. Leo itajipa ama kegita, nipoza tu kwa chua. Minadai change, minadai njia. Minadai dengo, vata nipigania. Tunadai fame, tunadai madinga. Na iwezi kuwa tukilenga hizi shida.
Ana run the world, ana piga mboka, zero scandalous. Dunia nzima deserve a kind of love. Usibishane na unajua formula. Ahana smile. Kame na wiri na wiri. Mkononi bangili bangili. Unanifanya na isi kama tajiri tajiri choki kamili kamili.
Woman you run things, woman you run my world and I'm counting. Counting on you, nyangu shangi. And I'm loving the view, you know. I love to see my girls on top. Yeah, yeah, run things. Woman you run my world and I'm counting. Counting on you, nyangu shangi. And I'm loving the view, you know. I love to see my girls on top.
Okay, siki anafunga ndoa, marry you. Menisafisha madoa, niko wingu la blue. I'm gonna stick with you for wherever I'm coming through. Mambo ya kienda mbaya, I'm gonna keep you cool. kama ulisafa sahau karibu sapa kwa bahati nzuri mapenzi anaishi hapa sikio mpata sina matata jisifi waka pendeza takata cash mkononi kwenye mahitaji takupenda moyoni nikupenda fasi takwa rambo ndone vita maji maji sitokutenda kutenga sitokujaji
naomba sana naomba dua nisije zingua nobody
nobody love me the way that
nobody,
nobody.
Wanasema sana, wataongea, wazidi umbea, nobody.
Nobody can be the way that
you. Nobody.
Nobody can not be the way
that you. Oh, and I know, and I know, and I know, and I know, and I know. You're the one for my heart and soul.
Nobody can be the way that you.
Nobody.
Nobody can not be the way that you.
Nobody can love me the way that you. Nobody can love me the way that you do.
Nobody.
Baby panda mti kama network ni blanda I'm on a romantico Better option ni wewe safwa elewe I'm on a romantico Nimekunokia na techno kuhanga papana I'm on a romantico Better option ni wewe Leo nimebai bamba Leta mamako tuonge Tuliko sana tangu masikio ni toboe Hii namba ni ya mse wa movie hapa base Usireply hata kikutext Uliwacha kubonda Tangu kikuzenu zende missing Miliyate kushuku ule mkisi Kuna ukame Na hopa bako aliunda fence Na gopa sano kuliwe na fizi I'm on a romantico Baby panda mti kama network ni blanda I'm on a romantico Better option ni wewe safwa elewe I'm on a romantico Nimekunokia na techno kuhanga papana I'm on a romantico Better option ni wewe Kielewe, kielewe, kielewe Lazima ni kuweke, kielewe, kielewe
DJ Legend.
I don't want to you to the waste my time. I don't wanna wait till it's all over. Cause life is a gift from the most high. That is why I'm thankful for all I have. Cause the fast life really ain't all that. So now I try to be pure. No be like say I know this shit no man. I just get better in job. Waiting to see for this life plenty. I keep up for my belly.
DJ Legend.
I let the room in the dark cause my blink is a torch
watch fashion, that's a day in the mirror that I saw. Shaping like a ball, we go ball. Flex the detour, I go set to the front. No return, and when I enter the club, no day my front, cause me I get the gun. No day do me wrong. Oh, I'm a fashion killer, yeah. I got much deliver, yeah. When I pass you, shiver, yeah. And my ascot, take out, yeah.